Now that we have the monoblock installed on its bracket outside, we need to plumb the monoblock into our existing radiant floor heating system. First, after shutting off the water, we'll tap into the pipe that brings the water from the radiant floor loop to the boiler.
The idea is that we have this valve here in between these two T's so that the flow can either go this way straight through, or if we close this valve and open these two, the flow will go this way out to the buffer tank and back. And this is a deburring tool here, which you can use to get rid of those burrs.
Does that come with a shark bite?
This is a shark bite tool that you can buy. And it allows you to mark how deep where the line should be so that you know that you got the full insertion. And it also has this little metal disc here that will cut the edge off of these pipes so that you have no sharp edges that would harm the O-ring that's in here that makes the seal. I'm checking for burrs. No burrs, it's all good. And clean. So now we put this in here. Okay, so we're gonna put this like this, and then we just push on this. And then this is done. Okay.
So when you said you marked the copper with the marker, you're not using those markings necessarily while you're putting the copper in.
Yes, you are. This is, you want to make sure that it's gone
all the way
in.
It still shows, because I didn't see you check that, so I was just curious.
Well, I could kind of feel that it
okay.
bottomed out,
okay.
and I can see
right.
that
okay.
it's up to the mark. I've deburred these and cleaned this up.
And did you use part of that copper pipe as the inserts, too?
Yeah. This piece of copper here is in.
Okay,
so now what we do is we push on this.
How are we going to get the other pipe in?
Well, I'll show you. Okay, that one's in, and then this can be slid over like this.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, now we got to push this together until this line ends
right.
up over there.
Right, okay, I'll let you push.
Okay, close enough. We have this open and these two closed.
So now you can actually put the water back in the system.
Yeah. Then we open up. This is the autofill.
And that is the part of the valve system that is then going to connect into both of the holes of the buffer tank.
When these two outer valves are closed and the middle valve is open, the water returning from the radiant floor flows directly to the boiler. When we close the middle valve and open the other two valves, the water will take a detour to the buffer tank, where it will mix with warm water from the monoblock before returning back to the boiler. Next, we connect the buffer tank to the monoblock with two runs of 1-inch PEX tubing. One run brings the cooled water into the monoblock for heating, and the other sends out the warmed water to the buffer tank. Next, we need to install a circulator pump between the monoblock and the buffer tank.
So this guy, the circulator, is going to go like this. It'll be roughly like right here. It'll be held up by the plumbing, and then I'll have some U-clamps, a piece of wood here, tie it in. This will all tie into this, and I'm thinking that I might just bring all the way down to here.
The cooled water leaves the buffer tank from the lower pipe and heads into the circulator pump, which pumps the water to the monoblock. The upper pipe brings the warmed water from the monoblock into the buffer tank, which provides the warm water for the radiant floor system.
This is not at the same level as this. So the way this is going to work is it's going to come out here, and then it's going to go like this.
Okay.
And that way I can transition.
Oh, and you can take it at any angle too. So
yes,
that's
exactly.
Right. Okay. So
well, yeah, and I just have to be careful to
make sure everything's in a straight line.
See, if I go here, this is a straight line. This is a straight
yeah.
line. Where those two intersect is where these go. So right now the elbows would go right about here. What we're trying to do here is figure out how long to cut the copper piece here and here so that they meet up exactly. 32 and a quarter to the end of the stick.
Okay.
And this distance here is 3 3/4. So we're going to mark where the pipe ends up on this fitting. The insertion depth of these things is 1 7/8. The pipe will end up here. Now, but that is not at the center line. If we look at the center line is right here. And if we measure the difference between these two, we find that that is, I'm going to use the 1 inch mark, that is 7/8 of an inch. So it's important to mark the insertion depth on these pipes so that when you push it together, you know that you've got it inserted the whole way.
You've got it long enough to insert it the whole way.
Well, yeah, you want to make sure that it's not partially inserted. Mm-hmm. And it's really hard to tell unless you mark it like this.
Right.
Now, it turns out that both the piece, the short horizontal piece and the short vertical piece are the same length.
Maybe it's better to do those first because the longer one, it has a little more flexibility.
Yes, you're right. That's a really good idea. We're going to shove this in here. So we just press on this. Okay.
That's in. Okay.
That's in. You can see it's in because it
goes
up to
the magic
marker.
Right, met the line.
Yeah. And then we take an elbow and we put the elbow on.
You have to make sure that that's straight now.
Well, it spins though.
So. Oh, that's right.
We spin, so that's on.
Right.
See, it's up there. Okay, and then we're going to put this one in.
Oh my God. Okay.
Okay, that one's in.
All right.
And then we take the long one.
Which also you also marked. How did you know how long to cut the vertical one?
So the way I figured that out is I measured the height of this pipe off the ground.
Okay.
I measured the height of the middle of this pipe off the ground.
Okay, and took the difference.
And then took the difference
two.
And subtracted 1 3/4, which is the 7/8 and 7/8.
Okay.
Add it together.
For the elbow itself.
For the elbow itself, yeah. Okay, so this one goes in. Okay, so that's in there.
Okay.
And then this guy is gonna go like this. And then this guy goes like this.
Oh my goodness, Claude. Oh my goodness, we did it! We made the pipes meet, and only two elbows. So you really did all the corners. This is my idea, huh? This thing, to have two elbows to get it out of the way.
The extra elbow, too.
Because otherwise we would have had a crash of the two pipes. So that was the way to solve that problem.
Exactly.
And those two valves are now in the shutoff position, I believe, right?
Yes.
This concludes how we plumbed the monoblock into the radiant floor system. Be sure to watch part 5 on putting the antifreeze into the system. Please subscribe and give us a super thanks if you can.